You are being microwaved. The purpose of this video is sort of the other half. It's about countermeasures to protect you from intentional exposure to pulsed microwave communications equipment. The other video I made was the mental countermeasures, knowledge, getting rid of doubt, understanding how the system works and what its goal is probably the biggest countermeasure. We're going to get in more physical countermeasures, things that can protect you. According to the US Army, metal, obviously. I don't mean to be naive here. I'm sure some of you live in apartments. I'm sure some of you, money doesn't grow on trees, but it has to be said, a metal roof may be the best protection you can get. It's delivered by satellite, it's above you. If you can afford it, do it. Understand your life is on the line. If you're a targeted individual and you're being attacked day and night, you may need to make serious changes to your life. If you could find, a cheap, live in the worst trailer you can find if it's got a metal roof. If you can rent a cabin from someone, do it. If you have a family member that'll allow you to build a little cabin in the back of their house so that you could afford to do it and put a metal roof on it, do it. Sleep in the middle. This comes straight from Dave Case, the anti-tinnitus V2K. Sleep in the middle. Obviously, it's coming from above you. So the closer you are to the middle of the house, the steeper the angle has to be to get. Remember, it's a pulse microwave beam. It's a straight shot. It's not broadcast like radio. It is a beam, a direct beam. They have to have line of sight or line of satellite. So if you're in the middle, the satellite has to be farther to the side to get under the metal roofing to attack you. If you sleep at the edge of the house, it's so much easier. They can just come right through the sidewall. You know what I'm saying? Sleep in the middle. Cellulose insulation in the attic. Huge, huge. Cellulose obviously is recycled paper, treated and used as insulation. This stuff is the best insulator. It has so many great properties, but to a targeted individual or anyone, once they accept that this is happening, it will that's block so much, but disperse. Pulse microwaves, they don't like wood. And of course, paper is made of wood. So it's basically what you're doing is just, it might as well be sawdust, from a functional standpoint. The stuff is amazing. Obviously, it's going to reduce your energy costs, which is nice too, but that's not the purpose of this video. If you are financially able, and again, I don't mean to be naive, I understand it costs money, it's not cheap, but you know what? When your life depends on it, when your family's life depends on it, make it work. Sell your Harley, dare I say. You're going to be using the countermeasure from binaural beats. It's not a countermeasure, but it functions as such. The binaural beats from anti-tinnitusv2k.com, right? Even John Hall's Guinea Pig's book backs that up, that binaural beats within certain frequencies neutralize and interfere with how the pulse microwave beam is interacting with your central nervous system. It's being pointed at your temples. And around the ear for the V2K microwave auditory effect, so it can gain access to your central nervous system, right? What the countermeasures do is basically sort of, it's almost like a blocking wave. It comes at the same, either at the same frequency or a frequency that will counteract or cancel it out. So use that. You're gonna be using the Kost headphones as recommended by Case Electronics. You're going to listen to it at night, obviously. Wear foam earplugs at night so that you can turn the volume up higher than would normally be comfortable otherwise. The foam earplugs have a secondary effect is that they also help sort of block and protect access to the nerves in the ear, which are critical to how the attacks work. Play that all day long. When you wake up in the morning, turn the volume up on it, put it on a table, leave it there. If you have speakers that go up to 25,000 hertz, even better. But the headphones are just mini speakers, right? So turn the volume up as high as you can. It won't be very loud, but it's good enough. And it's off in the distance and you'll be hearing it throughout the day and it will be doing its job. As Dave Case says, the louder the better and the more the better, right? The longer you've been exposed to pulse microwaves, the longer it's going to be to undo the way the attacks are working on you. Because remember, they've been using that pulse microwave beam, which transmits and receives information, to brain scan you and get your EEG the whole time and gather other information and sort of crack your code. And this blocks it. So now the satellite and the AI that runs the system is getting less information from you. It's much less about stopping an attack than it is giving them the information they need to create and to construct the way it's attacking your brain. So it's basically blocking, you know, you're starving the beast, so to speak. Listen to that throughout the day. Go to bed early. Remember, these satellites are powered by the sun. When the sun comes up in the morning, the satellites become more powerful. Now, of course, they're attacking you at night. They're attacking you when you're sleeping because the body is, one, it's still and it's not a moving target. And two, when you're sleeping, the brain becomes susceptible to the attacks. If you are unlucky enough to work at night and sleep during the day, you are really going to get it because the satellite is powerful and you're sleeping, you know, while the satellite is the most powerful. If you have the option to get to bed early enough so that you can wake up early enough, you'll notice something if you're a targeted individual that they want you to stay up late. All of a sudden, like for some reason, you'll get, you know, like your third wind at like 8 o'clock or something like that because they want you to stay up late and then sleep in early so that you can get a powerful version of the attack in the morning after the sun comes up. Obviously, if you live on the East Coast, let's understand how the sun rises in the east, right? Or the sun rotates to the sun in the east. If you're on the East Coast, you're going to be the first to be attacked. Now, that's a bit of a disadvantage because let's say you live in California and you're being attacked. The satellite is going to become more powerful. Like, you know, if it's 6 a.m. in California, it's already 9 a.m. on the East Coast. So the people on the East Coast are essentially the only people that can be attacked because the satellites that are over the top of the West Coast aren't in the sun yet. So they don't have their full power. So the people on the East Coast are going to get it a little harder. That's just a little sort of factoid there, something to think about. Run the countermeasure all day long, listen to it all day long. Remember, it needs information from you to crack your code and attack you. A lot of people think out loud, right? They verbalize their thoughts. You know, they're trying to work through something and they're like, oh, you know, I should probably fix it. You know, they just kind of do that. They're not talking to themselves like crazy people. They're just thinking out loud, you know, talking through something or even just ranting. You know, you watch TV and you're mad at something and you're like, can you believe this? You know, Bill Burr, I love that Bill Burr bit. You know, it's like, no, they crashed the economy and they get a bonus. What's up with that? And he's yelling at the TV. Don't do that because the satellite has got a laser listening device. You know, old school spy technology. The laser is pointed at the window and it's taking the vibrations off the window and it can hear what you're saying. I mean, this is like 50-year-old spy tech, you know, obviously. They can hear what you're saying and the microwave beam is scanning your brain waves and getting that information. And then the computer is putting the two together. You know, there's the piece on 60 Minutes there where they put people in, you know, basically like an MRI and they asked them to think of a picture. And then the machine, the computer, tries to guess what picture they thought of based on their brain scans. And the computer does a pretty good job of it. Well, that's child's play. Like if they're doing that in a lab today, that means world militaries had that 40 years ago, patented the technology and then didn't tell anybody because that's what militaries do. Nothing wrong with that. You know, I mean, they don't want it to fall into the wrong hands. Problem is, you know, when the Chinese and Soviets have that and they're using it on us, that's kind of a problem. So understand that. Become a person of few words if you can, right? Talk less, say more. Don't rant. Don't get mad. Don't verbalize things unless you have to. And I'm not saying don't talk to your friends. Absolutely socialize, live, laugh, love, be normal. But don't, when you're by yourself, don't, again, this is about starving the beast, right? Don't give the beast any more food. So keep your mouth shut because you're giving them two pieces of information that they can mash together. And they can say, I know when he says this, the brain waves look like this. And then later I can use that against to attack them. You're giving them information, so don't do it. I think that was part of my other video. So this sort of became a little bit of that as well. But we're getting on to 10 minutes. I try to keep them to 10 minutes. So that's basically hardware countermeasures, functional scheduling countermeasures, and a few ways to protect yourself. So thank you for watching the video, and good luck.